Students of the martial arts begin their life-changing journey by first accepting the teachings of those who have gone before. As the student progresses and the years pass, it becomes natural to question the lessons of others through self-discovery and analysis. The student eventually goes beyond the rigidity of the style and finds his own path. This is the inescapable cycle of Shuha Ri that we're going to discover today on Black Belt Life. Welcome to Black Belt Life, the weekly talk show where we talk about the journey to black belt and beyond. If you're new to the channel, welcome. Hajime Mashite, pleased to meet you. And please join us each week by subscribing so that you don't miss an upload or a live broadcast. You will also help our channel to grow and get the word out about the work we're doing here to preserve and grow the traditional martial arts. In part one of our series on Budo no Shinrigaku, or martial art psychology, we talked about the underlying principle of Kokoro, or Shin, which is heart, mind, spirit. We discovered that these are not separate entities that we are trying to unite as one, they are one. Our task on our journey is to hone and polish the Kokoro through years of arduous training into a highly skilled warrior, a perfection-seeking artist, and a polished, honorable, and respected human being. Today in part two, we are going to discuss the concept of Shuha Ri, which is a term used to describe the overall progression or cycle of martial arts training. Shuha Ri is the lifelong relationship a student will appreciate with their instructor. Now, this is usually discussed as a philosophical concept of the martial arts, but there are definitely some psychological points in Shuha Ri. After all, isn't there philosophy in psychology? Or is there psychology in philosophy? Anyway, maybe they're both as one. It's going to upset some psychologists and philosophical people. Anyway, one of those things that makes you go, Shuha Ri are different stages of our martial arts journey. However, they are not always in a step-by-step progression. Think of them as necessary steps that usually happen in sequence, but may correspond with each other like overlapping circles. There is Shu within Ha, and both Shu and Ha within Ri. I know that probably sounds confusing, but we'll get into that later. Let's define each stage separately and then talk more about how they come together. Shu usually means to obey or follow, but can also be translated as to protect. The dual meaning of Shu is a description of the relationship between a martial arts student and teacher in the beginning stages of training. It's very similar to the relationship of like a young child with their parent. The student must follow instruction to the letter, absorbing every detail and repeating techniques hundreds, if not thousands, of times. And it is imperative that the student learns every technique correctly, follows the rules, and accepts all correction and constructive criticism. This level stresses the basics in strict fashion so that the student has a solid foundation to prepare them for moving into higher stages. Even though their body types, personalities, backgrounds, abilities, and age may differ, all students must perform the techniques in identical fashion in order to fit the style. The protect meaning of Shu is the teacher's responsibility in the relationship to guard and watch out for the student's best interests. Constant encouragement, correction, discipline, and the right amount of praise are necessary for the teacher to nurture the student through the growing years, much like a parent protects and guides a child. The Ha is the stage that most begin to enter after reaching black belt. Ha is breaking free or diverging from some of the rules they followed so staunchly in the Shu stage. A fresh black belt will start to discover how many different ways the fundamentals they learned can now be applied in more imaginative and creative ways. This is usually a stage that may frustrate the teacher as the student asks over and over again, why? But because of the questions and the introspection, the student's own individualism in the way they perform techniques will begin to blossom. They begin to understand that most of the rules can be broken, or at least bent sufficiently in order to foster a higher interpretation and understanding of the techniques. The relationship between the student and the teacher should develop into a much closer bond and respect for one another. The teacher is the master of the art, but the student now becomes an instructor of others, which leads to an even further journey of discovery. As a high-ranking black belt, the re stage represents breaking free from the instructor. The student has learned almost all that the teacher has to offer, yet still seeks their wisdom and counsel when needed. The relationship between the two is much stronger than ever, even though they have separated, much like an adult child ventures out into the world, but hopefully taking along the parents' advice. Hopefully. Because of the wonderful times they've shared, their relationship now reaches new heights as the teacher lets go to allow the student to learn more through self-discovery than through personal instruction. After breaking the rules in the ha stage, the student now creates and invents new rules in the re stage. The technical style of the student is now a showcase of their own personality and experiences shaped by the teacher's years of showing the student the path of the way. As an example, Soki Shogo Kuniba had a very advanced student, a fourth degree black belt, a good friend, Mark Boyette. He had studied some martial arts before. He studied Wing Chun and some other things. Got all the way up to fourth degree black belt under Soki. He was one of his team members. He was really, really sharp. And he went to Soki one day and just said, "I've always wanted to continue my study in Wing Chun. Would that be okay?" And Soki Kuniba basically said, "Absolutely." Okay, didn't try to talk him out of it. Said, "Please." Because he understood that it was time for Mark to move on and discover what he needed to discover. And Mark became one of the best Wing Chun guys around. So that restage is very important. As you can see, there is Shu in the Ha, and both Shu and Ha in the Re. The progression is a cycle that for many of us that have been around for decades, we have seen over and over again. The student embraces the kata, diverges from the kata, and then discards the kata. Well, doesn't throw it out. I still practice all my kata. But they understand the techniques, the kata, the applications to a much higher level. Shu is the person who follows the rules until they sink in. Ha is when they reflect on the rules, looking for exceptions and bends or breaks the rules. Ri is when they become the rule and develop mastery of the essence and underlying forces. From the practices to the theory, and finally to the self-awareness, Shu Ha Ri binds the teacher and student together through their shared experiences, knowledge, trials, training, and traditions. A fourth level of Shu Ha Ri can be added, in my personal belief. This is where the psychology really plays its part. Shu is where we learn to follow the rules and solidify our basic knowledge. Ha is where we collect further knowledge and start to bend or break the rules. And then Ri is a level of inventing and creating by blending the things we've learned in the past with the present discoveries. The final stage, I believe, is Kokoro, where we begin to simplify everything as one. Our understanding becomes simpler as we create more from within. We should all want our students to become better than we ever were, both in knowledge and skill. This is the path for growth in any art. The student must surpass the master or the art will stagnate and fester. If the student never achieves the teacher's skills and ability, the art will deteriorate. However, if the student can absorb integrate all of the teacher's knowledge and capabilities and progress into a higher level of understanding, the art will continue to grow and thrive for generations. I hope you've enjoyed today's concept of Shuhari. Please feel free to hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, please, if you're new to the channel or if you haven't subscribed yet. Bad. Hit that button. Oh, it's over there. Okay, hit the button. And also join us next week as we go through another part of Budo psychology. Thanks for joining us and see you next week on Black Belt Life.